the outrageous incompetence and inefficiency of the High Command have tried my patience and that of my hard-pressed army long enough. By my faith, I swear, it would be better that those gallant generals, Essex and Manchester, took up swords with the king. For then might we be assured of victory.
Yes.
For by their reluctance to pursue this war with the intensity it demands, they have proved themselves treacherous, both to our cause and to this nation.
Yes. If we beat the king 99 times, he will still be our king and we his subjects. If he beats us but once, we shall all be hanged.
If that is so, then why in the bowels of Christ did we take up arms against him in the first place? Gentlemen, honest men have served us faithfully, and many have died, that this house may sit in freedom and this nation live in liberty. In the name of God, I beseech you, do not desert them now. Unless Parliament supports this war to the full, I am bound to say in all conscience that I will lay down my sword and let this house make its peace with the king, be that peace ever so base. I move that this house demands the immediate resignation of the High Command upon the grounds that they be no longer competent to command the armed forces of this Parliament.
Order! The motion has been proposed. Let it now be put to the question. Those against Colonel Cromwell's motion?
No!
Those in favor of the motion?
Aye!
The ayes have it, the motion be carried.
Hooray! I move that Colonel Cromwell be appointed Commander-in-Chief of the Army.
Hooray!